بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم There is a group of حروف known as حروف مشبه بالفعل حروف مشبه بالفعل فعل means verb مشبه means resembling There are in fact حروف but they look like verbs They are six in number إن أن كأن ليت لكن لعل Inna, anna, ka anna, laita, lakinna, la'alla. Inna, anna, ka anna, laita, lakinna, la'alla. Inna is indeed. Anna has got two meanings, indeed. And that Ashhadu Anna Muhammadan Rasulullah Ashhadu Anna Muhammadan Abduhu wa Rasuluh So this category is causing the Mubtada to go to the Nasab form Inna Allaha Ashhadu Anna Muhammadan Ashhadu Allah Ilaha illallah That is another construction Muhammadan is clear Ashhadu Anna Muhammadan Muhammadun How it becomes Muhammadan That is because of Anna Inna indeed Anna indeed as well as that Ka Anna as if As if Ka Anna hu waliyun hamim As if He is your best friend
Best of the best.
Right? Then, Laita. Alas. Laitani. Laita ana turns Laitani. Lakinna. But. But in fact, now bring the examples from the Quran. Inna.
Inna Allah
ma'as-sabirin. Basically, the sentence Inna Allah ma'as-sabirin. But the addition Inna causes the mubtada word Allah to go to the nasab form, and the khabar remains the same. Inna Allaha ma'as sabirina. Ma means with sabirin, those who endure. Right? Inna Allaha ma'as sabirin. Actually, sabr is the Arabic of two English expressions patience as well as steadfastness. It's more in the Quran for steadfastness than the patience. For the patience, it comes negatively. In Surah Tur, it has been said that the people in the hell will be asked, "Fasbiru aw la tasbiru, sawaun alaykum, innama tujzawna ma kuntum ta'malun." Whether you bear it patiently or you cry, it's all the same. You are being rewarded for what you have been doing. So, with a negative sense. Lekin normally, sabr is basically one who is steadfast. Not gold, but only men can make a people great and strong. Men who for truth and honor's sake steadfast and suffer long. What is the difference between patience and steadfastness? Patience is after an event. What happened? You will how to respond after the event. If you don't cry, you don't make complaint, then you are doing sabr, patience. But steadfastness is that you are being threatened that if you do that, you will have this treatment. You said, no, it's right, I have to do it. Comfort me. This is actually perseverance or steadfastness. So Quran mostly uses the word sabr in the second meaning. That is the real greatness. Are you with me?
Yes.
So inna, another example, more examples from this side. اعلموا انما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو وزينة اعلموا ان الله على كل شيء قدير But if it is innama in Suratul Kahf in the morning prayer I recited today in Fajr last ayat of Suratul Kahf قل انما انا بشر مثلكم يوحى الي annama ilahukum ilahum wahid. So because it is innama, so it's not ilahakum. Otherwise it would have been inna ilahakum, but it is innama ilahukum. Again innama ilahukum ilahum wahid. Faman kana yarju liqa rabbihi falyamal amalan salihan wala yushrik bi ibadati rabbihi ahada. Wa'lamu anna fikum rasulallah. Anna Fikum Rasulullah. So Rasulullah turns to Rasulullah because of Anna. Walamu.
After Anna is Fikum.
You know, Fikum has been brought earlier, but the ism remains the same.
There are
lengthy principles that how can you brought earlier this and that. But the fact is that the basic sentence was Anna Rasool Afikum. The basic sentence was Anna Rasool Afikum. But Fikum has been brought earlier to emphasize in you is there is Allah's Messenger. So, Walamu Anna Fikum Rasoolallahi. Law yutiyukum fi kaseerin min amri la'anittum. وَلَاكِنَّ اللَّهَ حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمْ الْإِيمَانِ. You know, in the same ayah, two examples. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Remember, note, that among you is Allah's messenger. If he listens to you in most of the things, لَعَنِتْتُمْ, you will be in trouble. وَلَاكِنَّ اللَّهَ. In fact, Allah has حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْإِيمَانَ. Allah has made iman more loving to you. وَزَيَّنَهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. And He has decorated you in your hearts. وَكَرَّهَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْإِسْيَانَ. And He has made kufr, disobedience and rebellion hateful to you. Iman wakarra ilaykum kufra wal fusuq wal isyan ulaika humur rashidun fazlan min allahi wa ni'ma. So that is lakinna. Example of lalla, numerous examples. Yeah, but numerous example, we can't study until we study the pronouns. But if you have with noun, come with it. The picture of this chart should be engraved into your mind.
There's three columns.
Yeah, there will be three in this direction. Singular, Muthanna, and plural. Third person pronouns. Third person. You know what is third person? Yes, he, she, it. Second person, you. And then first person, I and we. In second and third person, there is a division between masculine and feminine. Masculine, feminine. Masculine, feminine. And then in the first person, there is no division between musanna and plural. There is only one division between singular and the rest. Singular and plural. Since pronouns in Arabic are also nouns, you know, we studied them under the heading of nouns. Since they are nouns, so what should they have? Since they are nouns, so they should have all the characters of noun. Means? Definite or indefinite? So they are definite. We have already studied under the heading of definite nouns. One was pronouns. So they are all definite. Then there will be number, singular, plural, singular, musanna, plural, it's there. Then masculine, feminine, it's there. And then i'rab. Most important thing, since they are nouns, they must have i'rab. And the i'rab of the pronouns is very, very interesting. If it clicks you, you get it in a second. But if you miss it, the whole life you will get confused in it. Very, very interesting. First of all, we'll study nouns in the rafa form. So hold this chart in front of you. Is of the rafa form. Pronouns in the rafa form are always independent complete word. Independent complete word. Whereas the pronouns in nasab and jar form are never a complete word. They are always appendix of a noun, a harf, or a verb. So they are always independent. So they are called detached pronouns. And they are, third person is huwa, he. Huwa. And she is hiya. She. Then both of them, musanna would be huma. They too. This two is the same. Huma. They two. Plural of masculine is whom. They all men. And if they are women, and you have to say they would be hunna. They all women. You nominative form, nominative case is anta. Why I am saying that nominative case? Here I didn't mention nominative case. I simply said he, she, they. Why did I say they nominative form? Nominative case. Why did I say that? Because in English, you is a very universal word. It is for one, it's for two, it's for ten, hundreds, and it's for men, it's for women. It is nominative case as well as objective case. So I had to mention anta, you nominative form. You singular, you man, you masculine. Nominative case. And its musanna would be antuma. And its plural would be antum. All nominative cases and masculine. You two men and you all men. Nominative. Nominative case. And for feminine, it would be anti. And musanna would be same, like third person. Antuma. You, feminine. Nominative. And you two women, nominative. And antunna, you all women, nominative. Ana is I. You know, it is written as Ana, but read as Ana. Alif is not pronounced. Written as Ana, but read as Ana. Urdu jaisi galat kehne meri Ana majru ho gayi. Wo Ana majru hundi. Because it's an Arabic word. I. Now there is no dispute because I is nominative. And then we. We'll come after Salat, inshallah. Nahnu, sorry. Nahnu. We. Now, the chart. Domair pronouns in nasab and jar form. These are detached. In Arabic, they are called Damair Munfasila. Fasil means distance. Detached. Damair Munfasila. Detached. Detached pronouns are Damair Munfasila. Detached pronouns are Damair Munfasila. These are Damair Muttasila. Damair Muttasila. Muttasil means attached. Muttasila. Attached pronouns. Attached pronouns. Again, same boxes. As I said, transfer this picture into your mind. Now, most of the Arabic will be just the fill in the blanks in this. As the name indicates, these are detached ones, independent words, no attachment. They are always attached to an ism, fail or harf. The pronoun in nasab and jar form cannot be an independent word. It has to be attached to a noun, fail or harf. So, I will write them like this with a line to tell you, to remind you, to engrave into your mind that they are attached. Attached who? Attached who? Reverse dhamma. Who? Attached huma. Don't say it's the same word. That is a full-fledged word. This is just a part of the word. Who attached who, attached whom, attached whom. Then attached ha. Attached whom. Attached hunna. This hunna and this hunna are two different words. This is in rafa form and this is in nasab or jar form. No, Arab is expressed in different ways. We have already studied. You have to scratch it out from your mind that Arab means Dhamma Fatha Kasra. Aren't you lost there? I can read from your face. Then, Ka. Attached Ka. Attached kuma, attached kum, attached key. You know, an has been removed and ta has been replaced by ka and attached. That was without an, it was ta tumatum ti tumatunna, and here it is ka kumakum ki kumakunna, but attached. Ki. Not ki, ki. Kuma. Attached kuma and attached kunna. Attached ki, attached kuma, and attached kunna. Attached ya with sukoon. Attached ya with sukoon. Must. And it must precede with a kasra. Remember. And then attached na. So this would be his and him. This will be her and her. You know, in English, her is objective case as well as possessive case. So I'm writing double, her and her. And this is there. This is also there. Bracket two, bracket two. This is same. This is masculine for feminine both. And home. There, sorry, and them also. Sorry, there and them. This is also there and them. This is there too, and this is there all. There are them all, but masculine. And this is there are them all, but feminine. All this is your. This is all, this is you and your both. You objective and your possessive. Your and you objective. One and masculine. This is you and your objective, you objective and your and one feminine. This is kuma, same. So it would be you objective and your but for two. And this is you are your all but masculine. And this is you objective and your for all feminine. Ye, me and my. Me and my. And this is us and our. I have written the whole chart thus that it gets engraved into your mind. Otherwise, it's a very simple concept. Now the application is he is hua, and what will be the Arabic of for him? Quick answer.
Lahu.
Lahu, mashallah. So It has to go to the jar form, and jar form of who is attached who. So lam will get attached to this who, lahu. And you can complete the whole chart. Lahu, lahuma, lahum, laha, lahuma, lahunna, laka, lakuma, lakum, laki, lakuma, lakunna. All familiar words for you. For a Muslim, all are familiar words. You simply need orientation. Where they belong to, right? And where they come from. Laki, lakuma, lakunna, li, lana. Ala, huwa, is he. Ala, on. On him, at him. So, alayhi. This according to the phonetic sound, because alayhu is impossible. It is against the nature of Arab to have bump in his speech. So whenever there is a bump, he will clear the bump. And it's this practice in English also. Do not, what it becomes? Don't. What's the difference between do not and don't? Don't is easy to speak, and do not is first you go, do not. So don't. Simple. So alayhi, alayhima, alayhim, alayha, alayhima, alayhinna, alayka, alaykuma, alaykum assalamu alaykum, alayki, alaykuma, alaykunna, alayya. No, it was already Allah with ya. One ya was already there, and we have to attach ya with this, so it will become alayya, on me, and alayna, assalamu alayna wala ibadus salihin, attahiyatu lillahi wassalawatu tattayyibatu assalamu alayka, look, ayyuhan nabiyyu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, assalamu alayna wa ala ibadillahis salihin. So everything is already known to you. You simply have to place them in the proper order, and then you know Arabic already. Is that clear? Any question?
Is that a sukoon on the ya, or me for my, me and my first person?
Yeah, this is sukoon on ya, but requirement is the there should be a kasra, the letter which is getting attached to it.
So, why is it alayya? Alayya. Why is there a fatha on the ya?
There is an exception, because it was tashdeed there.
Okay.
And this ala, this lam has to have fatha, and ya is with sukoon. Right?
Okay.
So, not fatha or dhamma. It's a practice. Normally, in other cases, they will put there. And sometimes, if it is not possible, they will add a small noon there. Zalama, he treated wrongly whom? Me. So, Zalama, meem has to have fatha. And ya needs a kasra before. So, they will add a noon there. Zalama ni. He treated me wrongly. So this noon is additional just to meet this requirement of kasra. But since ya was with sukoon and it was not possible to make that ya move, if the word was going to change altogether and its shape was going to alter. Because Allah, in fact, that ya had got no harakat at all. Allah, lam had a long fatha, and ya was just of maksura, alif maksura. So it didn't exist actually. So it has just been connected together with alayya. So your homework is, you have these two charts. Make as much practice as you can. You have got 17 huruful jara. At least 10 of them are very common. Ala, ila, fi, hatta. And best is that you make a blank chart, and as I said yesterday, make photocopies of it in hundreds, because then it's to be used again and again, and then fill in the blanks there. Right? So similarly with inna, innahu, innahuma, innahum, innaha, innahuma, innahunna, innaka, innaka antal azizul hakim, innaka, innakuma, innakum, innaki, innakuma, innakunna, inni, inna. So there's inni and inna.
Innana.
Actually, it is innana, but normally it is
inna.
Reduced to inna because it doesn't cause any confusion.